Hola padres, yo soy señora Meyer. Y este año, this year, we have a lovely Trinity intern, a bonus teacher.
Hola, my name is Ms. Acosta. It's nice to meet you guys.
And so very quickly, we want to share with you some basics about ourselves and how to get in touch with us. This will be my 15th year teaching Spanish and my second year at Lee High School. And Señorita Acosta, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Mm-hmm. I just graduated from Trinity University with a bachelor's in Spanish and Global Latinx Studies. This is my Master's of Arts in Teaching year, so I am studying to be a teacher next year.
Awesome. We are so glad to have her along with us, and she is here 4 days a week. So, all right, ladies and gentlemen, so first thing to show you is we have a fabulous class website that will help you and your students with any questions you have. First off is Spanish 1 and 2 classes can find their agendas and assignments right here when they click Spanish 1 or Spanish 2. And every week, all of our assignments are on this coordinated organizer, so they can see warm up, brain breaks, exit tickets, and it has everything they need linked in here for them. Everything is also in Google Classroom, and I'll show you that in a minute as well. We also have a virtual learning right here for them. If you're looking for the NEISD critical updates, click here and it'll take you there. We know students have had a lot of the same questions, and so Señorita Acosta created this to help guide them. So for instance, if they're missing something or if they're sick or they need some help, let's click. And so it kind of guides them to it and has links to go with everything, including tutoring times. Señorita Acosta, can you tell us a little bit about this?
Mm-hmm. So as a way to help your students with as much as what they need, we have offered tutoring times Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday mornings from 9 a.m. to about 9:35 a.m. And in the afternoons again on Mondays, Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays from 4 to about 4:30.
And to get to that and find the Zoom link, first off, they need to check this calendar right underneath. And you'll notice that it has each time listed. And so when you click, it will have a brief description and it'll have the Zoom link. And so when you click it, it'll take the students directly to it. And what happens is if that ever gets canceled or a meeting gets scheduled, we go ahead and update it so that the students always have the ability to know whether or not we will be there. And that way they're not sitting around waiting on us if we can't make it. So next part of the site, we also have, so that was under the contact and tutoring right here. We also have resources for the students, video resources. For you all, we have Parent Corner. And in case you didn't get the email or didn't get a chance to fill it out, we have a quick form that we would love to get from you all if you haven't already, where you can add your name here and we will add you to the Google Classroom. So you will get a weekly report of your students' progress in class in Google Classroom. The other thing is we have expectations. You click over here and you guys will notice it has our basic classroom rules. We have some rule videos for both in-person and virtual, and attendance, quick reminder, students are encouraged to join us in our virtual instruction. And if you can't attend class, if a student's absent or has an appointment, they have until 11:59 that same day to complete their classwork, and then they would be counted as present. We would go back the next 2 days later, they'll allow us to do it, to update the attendance. Please remind your students they need to be there at least 90% of the time. So out of a 60-minute class, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, if they miss more than 6 minutes, they're absent. But they could still be counted as present if they turn in all their work before midnight. Same deal, so for the Tuesday, Thursday, 90-minute classes, if they miss 9 or more, then they're absent unless they complete all their work. They basically, if they miss more than that, they become a virtual learner, and in that case, we are happy to give that back to them. In case you're wondering about our high school, we have B lunch. So if you have one of my Spanish 1 classes during second or sixth period, we have B lunch. So the students come to class, then we break for lunch, and then we come back to class and finish up there. Grading. Senorita Acosta is going to walk us through a little bit of the grading.
Sounds good. So our grading is broken up in the following ways. 40% of your students' grades will come from assessments and projects, and we have listed some of the various ways that we consider an assessment. For example, major projects or major unit chapter tests, and a little brief description is followed by these. 20% of the grading comes from their quizzes. This comes from vocabulary quizzes, grammar quizzes, and cultural quizzes. We give about a minimum of one per week, and it's really important for your students to just kind of keep up with these quizzes. They do affect their grade quite a bit. 20% comes from communication activities. This is just a lot of in-class work, so there's not a lot to do outside of class for that. And then the last 20%, sorry, could you go slightly higher, is classwork and homework. We do try to give them as not a whole lot of homework. We give them maximum 15 minutes of homework per night, and that is apart from anything, that is beside anything that they were unable to finish in class, which they are then expected to finish outside of class.
Sorry for messing you up there. We have our target language communication. We have a series of activities that are 5 to 10 minutes. And so those add up as different parts of evidence on what we call the tail rubric. And so this will help guide us through that process. And so it's weighted in heavily in the favor of the students so that as long as they're actively participating in the lessons and actively engaged in class and completing their work, those short assignments add up to big developments when it comes to their projects and things like that. And so, as she said, homework is very limited. We rarely assign homework unless they didn't finish assignment during class, then it becomes homework. Late work, 20% if it's one day late. After we take a test over that unit, then the late work is no longer accepted. So please encourage them to take care of late work as soon as possible. Absences, please have them go to our website, to our Google Classroom. So every time they're absent, every day they start with Google Classroom. I'm going to show you an example. And so you guys will notice that every day we have a post, so for right here, and that assignment is listed right here. So we've got the slideshow, which has all of our activities and links. They have an activity that they did together, and they had their test today. This was from Friday the 11th. And then we also have, here's their test and their exit ticket. So every day they'll have a slideshow, an exit ticket, and a video. And today's video got cut into two. So before lunch, after lunch. So every day they need to make sure they have the activities, follow along with us, and the exit ticket done. And today there were two other activities that we did that they actually turned in. So if they're absent every day before we leave at 4:30, these students will have a video posted so that they can easily watch the lesson exactly as we did it in class. And I try to cut out the dead part where there's nothing going on and we're waiting for students to work independently. And that way we can maximize the time of the students who have to do the asynchronous learning. As far as textbooks and other information, we don't actually have a textbook that we are using this year. And so if you look over here in the parent corner, you guys will see where it has the parent information form, but what will my student learn this year? And when you click on this assignment, you will get to see exactly what it is your student will be able to accomplish at the end of the year. And so, for example, how do I make new friends? How do I spend my time, interact with community, inspiring people to travel? And so the idea is that the students will be able to complete different tasks with what they're learning. It's not just grammar-based. It is all about what they can do with the language. So that's level one, and level two is right next to it. We've also got information here about logins, and where they can learn more, schedules to help you, and even the district's back to school plan for you. If they're having trouble with technology, the virtual learning, we've been putting up links for the students. For example, this week, this past week, they changed the settings for Zoom. District-wide, it's requiring a login. And so if you need those instructions, we went ahead and shared them here. They're also shared on Google Classroom. And so it goes by different devices exactly how to log in step by step. We use several platforms in this class for our language interaction. And so if your student is in their Google Classroom and they click the link for classwork, under here, there's two major links, important links and questions and answers. So the Q&A help will take you to that slideshow we showed earlier. The first one was sent out on August 22nd, the day before classes began. And so we've got meetings to our Zoom link for that class, contact and tutoring calendar, our class website, Remind, we have an account where students can get reminders of class starting, tests and quizzes updating. All of that kind of information can be found through the Remind account. Flipgrid is where we do our audio recordings, and Quizlet is where we have our vocabulary lists instead of a textbook so that the students can practice the vocabulary as we go. And all of those links are right here, again, in Google Classroom under the tab Classwork. And important, these will stay here all year for them. Otherwise, it's just a daily assignment listed right here. And we really look forward to working with you all this year. If you need us, our email address and other contact information can be found just below this video on this teacher website for Lee High School. And we just really are excited to meet your students and get to know them. And Senorita Costa, will you close us out?
For a really great year with you and your students, and we're very excited to see them once things are nice and safe for them to come back to school. Thanks so much for your time. Hasta luego.
Hasta luego. Mucho gusto.